settled. We had Zai on Sophie and we freaking settled. Zai, how much did you call for the ball when you had Sophie on?
Me, I'm saying, everybody in the gym knows me.
Ball! Ball! Throw the damn ball inside.
But if there's a guard on her, it shouldn't even be a thought process. That makes your life easy as a teammate. Like, I'm shooting the ball if I'm a shooter, but damn it, I'm gonna notice if Zai's got a guard on her back and I'm gonna throw that sucker inside. Come on.
I think the challenges are always, pretty consistent. Do you have kids that are bought into what it would take to achieve that goal? And that's always something that you've got to figure out in the moment. When you compromise, everybody's a little bit unhappy. We've asked every single player to compromise at some level with scoring. We've asked players to compromise at some level with role. I think the challenges that most teams face that are this talented are people aren't willing to sacrifice and compromise for a big picture goal.
Different on where you pick up and guard them. If they're quicker, obviously you've got to adjust.
You're kind of at the mercy of your team. You might think you have some unselfish players that are willing to sacrifice their individual goals, but in a big moment, do they really do that? The biggest fear for me would have been that I failed from a people standpoint of being able to try to paint a picture where they understood why we were sacrificing and what the end goal, the compromise was going to get, if we were able to be successful in that compromise and sacrifice.
The dad came up to me at West today, we had our meetings, and Randy goes, yeah, just tonight, just please take a look. And I was like, that's how they all think. But see, here's the deal, like, that's a setup, because nobody cares about our feelings. Nobody cares if we have a bad night. Nobody is gonna say, take it easy on them. You guys are going to be fine in 2 hours. The next 2 hours are not going to be fun. I mean, that's really what it is.
It felt amazing hitting that one kick, especially on the day that I did, like, West. I know so many people there, like, one of my cousins goes there. It's just, like, fun, and everybody was back from college, and it was a great atmosphere, and everybody was there to see it.
I've known Cameron 5 years. I knew her as an eighth grader. And because it's certainly not a four-year journey to score 1,000 points, it's countless car rides, countless AAU trips, countless times you had to put your arm around them and say, it's okay, I love you. If they didn't necessarily have their best game.
It's not just even a four-year accomplishment. I know it is. You did it in 4 years, but like you know dang well, it started with like old Larry lining up that, get that elbow in, girl, and whatever he did on the drive out in the backyard. I mean, it's bigger than just you getting to score in front of your friends, like all the stuff y'all did behind the scenes and everybody. Because like how many teams, if I'm like, come on, get Cameron too. And you guys were like, what the hell? She got like 20 and nobody even blinked at it. Like, oh, Cameron needs it? All right. It wasn't even like a question of why are you asking me to throw the ball to this kid right now when she's scoring more than anybody else. But it just was like, oh, okay. It's a cool group.
Very few things that are special are created without struggle and failure. That being said, I haven't let it enter my brain. If this happens, I don't have a speech ready. I don't have a pep talk to pick them back up. I guess I've just tried to keep my vision on the day that I'm on and not really gone down that road. I just don't believe that's gonna happen. And if it does, we'll cross that bridge when we get there.
You know the future of the bounce.
I understand that and I don't mind it. I like that there's a little fight right now. That's what the ref, Martin, just said, man. He said, this is an intense third quarter for a 25-point game. I said, well, I don't think that they're willing to, like, get off that ledge. Dad keeps screaming, wait till next year. Like, just do what you guys are doing right now with a focus on the offensive end that's a little bit better. I
just want to say, don't ever make it so normal, because this is normal, but don't make it normal where you can't celebrate the success. First quarter effectively ended the game. And sometimes it's the third quarter for us, sometimes it's the second. It just happened to be that you get out to a 30-0 lead or whatever it was, 28-0, I don't, 30-something.
We have been having this slump when it comes to the third quarter. We would be doing our best first two quarters, coming out strong at halftime. The score would be, we would rack up the points, and then we'd have this like almost slump in the third quarter where we would almost play like evenly or like play down to the other team. So like in practice, the way that coach would try and like stop this slump, we would practice the third quarter, and eventually the third quarter became our best quarter.
I think teams don't want to beat you right now. They just can't. They want to, they just can't.
Raiders on three, family on six. 1, 2, 3, Raiders. 4, 5, 6, family.
My family, I grew up here, went to Shawnee Mission North. I love that gym. It does bring back a lot of memories. If you're allowed to have a second favorite team, it's North. But I want to beat North as bad as I want to beat anybody. As long as your top group is in, I want us to be playing a certain way.
3-point game last year, right? Like there's still a little bit of a statement you guys wanted to make. It's difficult for me to give a pep talk to make a statement against North. And I understand that like you guys are sitting there saying, yeah, we're gonna win regardless, no matter how we play. So when coach said the other day, like, if you're not gonna do it for this, for the name on the front, do it for the name on your back, just in terms of this is how I compete. I don't wanna waste these. These are as good, and I don't wanna use the word practice. It's not a practice. It's like a limited amount of games we get, 25. So if I say this is just a practice, then I don't know how your mind frame is. This is an opportunity to play with your friends in front of a crowd.
Yes. Ready on three, family on six, 1, 2, 3, Raiders. 4, 5, 6, family.
Going into North, we felt pretty confident. We were just excited. I love playing in the North gym. I've grown up playing AAU games there, so it was super fun. And we were just excited to get a play together again.
So when the ball, I'll give him credit, when the ball goes inside in the paint, you guys are getting fouled. Like everybody is getting fouled, and they're not calling a lot. When we have it, I feel like it's a little different whistle. That's what you said the other day. It's a road whistle. And I feel like we get decent calls at home. When we're here, I don't expect anybody to give us a call. And stop, like I can tell right now, because I've never seen you look down as much as pregame and halftime, you're thinking too dang much.
At halftime of the North game, Western was like, Ashley, like the biggest thing right now that's stopping you is right in between your ears, which was true. I was just so in my head and I was not making anything.
I'll tell you when you need to do something different. Right now, the biggest thing that's hurting you from your shot is between your ears. Everybody in this gym wants you to shoot on our side. Everybody on their side doesn't want you to shoot. Just believe in yourself, because you can't. If you're thinking, how do I not miss this shot, it's going to be difficult. I just need you to start shooting like you don't give a shit about the result. And stop. If there's something we need to talk about later, fine. But right now, I need you dialed in for the next 16 minutes.
For me, when I know a shooter is capable and I know the hurdle is in between their ears, I'm not talking about it too much. And if I do address it, it's something quick to the point. But I think more so with Ashley, it's just, hey, girl, you're good. Stop thinking so dang much and let it fly.
You're open, you're gonna shoot the next one. And that's where I need you, that's where I need you. I don't want anybody, I want everybody to think the next one they shoot is gonna go in, and if it isn't, damn it, that's gonna add to our offensive rebound total. Come on, let's go.
Let's go.
Leave no doubt in the second half. I don't want this thing to be any sort of a weird, are we gonna get to 30? Leave no freaking doubt. Let's go, together on three. 1, 2, 3.
Together. Now redo it.
After the North game, I continued to shoot because that's what I was told to do. I still was not making anything, but I'm glad that I shot the shots and I just left that game in the past.
Well, the goal from the beginning's always been the same, to try to enjoy this thing. I say that and I know people don't maybe believe me, but just to have fun and enjoy every day.
The goal this season is obviously to win state, but I think we have like little goals in between. My goal is to be the best for my teammates and help the team be successful, and obviously help me grow for next year when I'm gonna have to be more of a leader.
So short term, obviously you wanna enjoy the whole ride, but long term, big picture, the ability for us to be able to really compete for a state title.
have a little bit more, I don't say cockiness, but just an era of like aura about you that you're walking in and you know you're the better team and you carry yourself like that all the time. Doesn't mean you're cocky. It doesn't mean anything other than just confident and ready. It's a limited 7 left, including sub-state. Part of that game is what did that. So like so she ends up 6 points away from me, and I of 1,000. So your next game will be her 1,000. Now here's the thing. I know you wanted to hit here, and I don't know if that's kind of the level of where you're like kind of distant with your thoughts right now. But you're gonna remember down there in this weekend. Like I always feel like this. The memories are always the midseason tournament, and really particularly the McPherson midseason.
Honestly. It was a little upsetting, you know, the crowd, the fans, in front of some of my family that came out. But I felt like it was still okay that I still got it. I'm happy that I still hit that mark.
You have a sports car. It's fun to drive it. When you know you have the team that you have, you kind of just want to watch it at times. Like, all right, let's go. We worked hard. I've been... stressful to you guys in practice. I'm complaining about everything we're doing wrong. That being said, I know we're pretty dang good. Just getting to watch them kind of play loose, we felt confident going into that game that we were going to have a good one. We'd had a good week leading up. McPherson's a famous gym, but just to get in the roundhouse and kind of let them play was exciting.
Going into the McPherson tournament, I knew it was going to be good. It's always been our breaking out moment and like the moment we like found our glue and like gelled together because we got that to hang out and it was just a great bonding moment.
Just say the same thing every time, don't change. Our best offense is how we rebound the ball, bottom line. Best offense is a missed shot at all. We'll be pressure on the first possession. It's not don't foul, it's adjust. Force them to make a decision that they're not gonna call the game so aggressively because we come out so damn aggressive.
Together, our red and the family on 6-1-2-3.
We were feeling pretty confident. We were just excited to be down there and be together, and we played really well.
The energy for us when we're on the road is always pretty good. People want to see us lose. And that was no different there, so.
Time you were in this gym, you had 15 in the first half. They ain't got nothing for you. Nobody can stay in front of you. Own the paint. First play is push after we go offense on the tip. Together on 3. 1, 2, 3.
Yeah. I might need to hit the town. I need you right here, right here. Hey, driving through the liquor store, faded, braided, hands in the waving, AZ.
They're running like earlier, harder, and it's like a pitch out here. Now this kid's having to run out, and now this kid's having to take this away, so they're us because this for them is faster than ours just defensively getting back. Like I feel like every time there's two people and there's one of us. What quarter is it? What quarter is it?
Third quarter.
Come on.
Together on 3, 1, 2, 3, together.
Got me when I send it past the ceiling, that stuck up. If your wife yet is not hitting you bust up. Every negative thing that they could have took from us, it kind of got amplified because y'all were whooping their ass on their own floor. Nobody wants that. But then, too, also, like, I think this, like, handling big wins, blowing people out, all right, you got to be able to handle that, all right, but still get every, like, I ain't telling y'all to tame it. Don't ever tame yourself, so celebrate, have all the success. But as soon as we walk out of here, got to be over and they got to be on to the next one. But to them, they got to learn how to deal with a 15-point loss, and they're going to have to deal with that shit for another night. So good job, Zay.
Hit somebody as hard as I possibly can. They don't barely move. They don't drop to a knee. They look at you and say, is that all you got? It's almost like, hold up, I messed up. I'm sorry. And that's where you guys have to get other teams on that kind of your breaking point, and then we're not going to talk shit other than some subtle shit. You're going to go back and tell your coach he said this. I'll do this another 30 years. It won't be something like this. You got a special group that you're a part of, so let's protect it at all costs. Tomorrow night, the Lakers South's going to figure out how good they are.
Win or lose, win or lose, that'll be a tough day. So you do this for a long time, and each class is unique, and each class is special. I'm gonna cry when we win, and it'll be sad, and I hope that we have four seniors that might be picked in the Missouri-Kansas All-Star game, and it would be a dream to be able to coach them one more game. I don't want the thing to end.
My feelings going into that championship game was like, play how we know how to play, like play together, keep it up, because it was a big game for us going against Olathe South, another Sunflower League team.
For the seniors to be able to finish it like that. Very happy to see Cameron and Josh go from that sophomore year where we got third place, and Ashley Van Elders had a breakout performance that tournament. So it was like those three, it was kind of a process where you saw that, and to come back and see this, you know there was growth. Just to see that group confident, and then to go down and obviously be able to finish it off was pretty cool.